Hello, welcome to the Google Ads Developer mini-series on logging and monitoring. In this introductory video, we'll discuss some of the benefits and considerations around implementing logging and monitoring for your Google Ads API integration. In later videos, we'll get into more detail about what a logging and monitoring solution could look like in practice, and we'll walk through a sample implementation using one viable solution, Google Cloud Logging combined with Google Cloud Monitoring. If you find this video useful, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to be notified of future videos. Let's get started with a high-level overview of logging and monitoring. Logging produces the most detailed source of information and is primarily helpful for debugging and investigation. On the other hand, monitoring is higher level, looks at user-friendly information, and is helpful for understanding the overall health of a system. Logging and monitoring can be closely related in that they cover different ways of understanding the same system. While logging provides data for in-depth analysis, monitoring captures real-time signals of system health to provide more of a bird's-eye view. In some cases, monitoring can be built on top of logs to view the data in aggregate. Logs are generated both on the server side by Google and on the client side by the API user. This video focuses on client-side logging, which includes some details passed back from the server. The Google Ads API client libraries provide built-in logging that provides information about each request and response. You may choose to implement additional logging on top of the default capabilities, as well as monitoring to visualize and alert on application health signals. Now that we understand the relationship between logging and monitoring, let's get into more detail about why we should implement logging and monitoring. What are the benefits? First, logging and monitoring provide greater visibility into errors and warnings so that you can trace, identify, and address issues quickly. Monitoring can help identify negative trends in application performance, and logs can help pinpoint the root cause. When working with the Google Ads API, enabling logging is required to get help from the support team to provide them with context about the issue you're experiencing. A second benefit is performance optimization. Logging and monitoring allow you to understand your application's performance by collecting and analyzing metrics. Doing so will help you identify areas for improvement and cost reduction. This also makes it possible to identify anomalies and send alerts when your application is not performing up to a given standard. And lastly, by understanding performance metrics, you can set your team up to better manage and prioritize resources based on metrics like latency and user demand. For user-facing applications, another benefit is improving the user experience. Logging and monitoring help to highlight application usage patterns, like how much time users are spending in different parts of the application and where they're dropping off. This data can be used to make informed business and marketing decisions. And finally, logging and monitoring are useful for auditing and security purposes. Equipped with a history of authentication and usage data, you can identify suspicious behavior and investigate malicious activity. Now let's talk implementation. We'll get into some detailed implementation considerations in the next episode, but let's pave the way for those details here. I want to stress how critical it is to implement a logging and monitoring solution before your application becomes generally available. These tools are crucial to fixing early issues and refining user experience in the context of your business goals. There are a lot of options for logging and monitoring, and only you can determine which are best for your project. Here are some considerations to factor into your decision around tooling, which will hopefully help you to build out an effective system for logging and monitoring. First, how will application performance be measured? What performance indicators do you care about, and what metrics will you use to capture these? Next, what events are important to track? You don't want to find yourself looking to make decisions without the data you need to reason through them. For example, you might want to track interactions with a particular feature to understand how users are engaging with that feature and make improvements accordingly. On a similar note, consider what data is needed for debugging purposes. Most logging tools will allow you to specify a logging level, such as debug, info, etc. It's important to think about what baseline information you would like to capture and what additional information you might want for investigating bugs and incidents. Lastly, where and how will log data be securely stored? This isn't a complete list, but rather a starting point. Once you identify what core data to log and monitor in your application, you can effectively choose a logging and monitoring solution that meets your project's needs. As we saw earlier, you get some logging for free if you're using a Google-supported client library for your Google Ads API integration. Each client library comes with its own logging configuration, which makes it simple to turn logging on or off, specify log levels, and configure output locations. These built-in logs include request and response details, including information about whether the request succeeded or failed, as well as a request ID, which can be helpful for debugging. However, they do not include application health signals, such as resource utilization. In Python, for example, logs are configured in a Google Ads YAML file. Each client library offers some language-specific variation. Okay, that concludes our introduction to logging and monitoring for your Google Ads API integration. In the next episode, we'll take the discussion a step further and look at some practical considerations around monitoring your application and implementing a logging and monitoring solution in the cloud. As always, we welcome your feedback and hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching.